For those who must succeed, part one. This is another year, and there is a task or some tasks that the Almighty God has assigned to each of his children. Nehemiah is a wonderful example of a man who started, continued, and finished the work that the Lord committed to his hand, and we want to learn together from his experience. In chapter 1, verse 2, Nehemiah said he asked Hanani and some other men of Judah about the Jews that had escaped, which were left of the captivity, and concerning Jerusalem. Nehemiah showed concern about the people of God, and from the answer he received, he developed a deep burden, which moved him into action. For you to even know what the Lord wants you to accomplish for him in this year or any other year, you have to be interested in knowing it, and you must consciously ask the Lord, like Saul, who later became Paul, did in Acts chapter 9, verse 6, Lord, what will thou have me to do? You must sincerely and genuinely ask God to show you what he wants you to accomplish for him, so that you can have a focus. Don't just attend your church prayer band meetings, choir practice, drama rehearsals, ushering department meetings, and so on, with no particular thing in mind that you want to accomplish for God. Let there be a task, a goal that you are pursuing. God is the only one that knows what he has for you, and as you ask him, he will tell it to you in a language that you will understand. The Bible says in Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 2, and the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon tables, that he may read, he may run that readeth it. You cannot run with a vision that you have not received. So search and find out what God wants from you. After deciding to embark upon the project of rebuilding the walls of Jerusalem, Nehemiah said in chapter 2, verse 13, and I went out by night by the gate of the valley, even before the dragon well, and to the dung pot, and viewed the walls of Jerusalem. Also, in verse 15, he said, then went I up in the night by the brook, and viewed the walls. The problem with a lot of Christians is that when they receive a task from the Lord, they rush into it without having the slightest understanding of what it is all about. The result is that many get weary after some time and give up, and the Lord has to look for someone else to complete the job. Such Christians are just like the seeds the Lord talks about in Matthew 13, 5-6. Some fell upon stony places where they had not much earth, and forthwith they sprung up because they had no deepness of earth. And when the sun was up, they were scorched, and because they had no roots, they withered away. Consider also what our Lord said in Luke 14, 28-30. For which of you, intending to build a tower, sitteth not down first, and counted the cost, whether he has sufficient to finish it? Lest haply, after he had laid the foundation and is not able to finish it, all that behold it begin to mock him, saying, this man began to build and was not able to finish. If you do not want to have an abandoned project in the ministry this year or any other year, follow the example of Nehemiah. He viewed the walls, wanting to know and understand the extent of the damage and of the work that needed to be done. Ask the Lord to give you an understanding of what he expects of you so that you can apply yourself to it. Go and learn more about the ministry you are involved in. There are many people in prayer groups who do not have the slightest idea of who an intercessor really is and what the work of an intercessor is. Many believe that it just entails attending a prayer meeting where you worship God and then someone comes up and gives prayer points and you pray and then the leader shouts, in Jesus' name, we have prayed. And then everyone shouts, amen. It goes far beyond that. There are many choristers who think that being in the choir is just about having a good voice and singing in front of the whole church. It is far deeper than that. After you have found out the task that God has for you and what it entails, you might react to it in one of two ways. It's either you think it's easy enough and you should have no problem accomplishing it, or you begin to feel overwhelmed because it looks very great and beyond you. Whether you think your God-given task is easy or difficult, the Bible says that by strength shall no man prevail. Do what Nehemiah did. In chapter 2, verse 20, he said, the God of heaven, he will prosper us. Therefore, we, his servants, will arise and build. Nehemiah expected all they would need for the work, including finances, physical strength, wisdom, knowledge, understanding, boldness, good health, security, and so on, to come from the God of heaven. You will discover that all through the book of Nehemiah, the man kept praying to the God of heaven. If you must succeed, do not depend upon past experiences, yours or other people's. Do not depend on your ability, eloquence, knowledge of the Bible, or anything else apart from God himself. He's the only one that can help you to succeed in accomplishing the task that he has for you. Stay connected to the Holy Spirit. Be prayerful. Ask God for direction every step of the way. Receive boldness from him. Just abandon yourself and his work in his hand and let him use you. Do not try to shut him out because you can never do it on your own, no matter how simple you think it is. Now, as you face your God-given task, Watch out for Sambalat and Tobiah and Geshem, because they will come and try to see if they can weaken your hand or take your focus from the task. They rose up against Nehemiah and his co-laborers in those days, but the people of God were victorious over them. Nehemiah chapter 4 from verse 1 to 3. But it came to pass that when Sambalat heard that we builded the wall, he was wroth and took great indignation amongst the Jews. And he spake before his brethren and the army of Samaria and said, what do these feeble Jews? Will they fortify themselves? Will they sacrifice? Will they make an end in a day? Will they revive the stones out of the heaps of the rubbish which are burned? Now Tobiah the Ammonite was by him, and he said, even that which they build, if a fox go up, he shall even break down their stone wall. These enemies were mocking Nehemiah and his colleagues, trying to make them feel small and incapable of achieving anything reasonable. They wanted them to feel like they were doing a useless work, so one that would neither stand the test of time nor be a blessing to anyone. But instead of giving up on the work, these Jews prayed to their God and continued with the work. When the enemy rises to make you feel that what you are doing is not making any difference in the work of the Lord, what he wants to do is make you begin to feel like you are wasting your time so that you can stop. But as long as you know that you received your task from the Lord, please keep doing it. Men may not notice you. You may never receive a pat on the back from anyone. You may even be criticized for doing what you are doing, but stay committed and focused, because as long as you play according to the rules of the one who has called you, you are making serious input towards moving his work forward. Now, note that Sambalat and Tobiah may not be human beings that you can see with your physical eyes, but spirits that you only hear and do not see. The devil may begin to whisper to your ears, telling you that that little thing you are doing for God in your closet is not going to help in any way to revive the stones out of the heaps of the rubbish which are burned. Just strengthen yourself in the Lord and go on. Do not let anyone convince you that what you are doing for God does not count. If God asks you to do it, then it is important, no matter how small or insignificant it appears. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name.